Jason, how excited are you to see RGD versus Team Secret?
I'm pretty excited for the
10
tournament as a
seconds
whole,
remaining.
actually, because there hasn't been much to see after the
Yeah.
big patch, so
Five
I'm kind of
seconds
curious as to see
remaining.
what all the top teams have been looking at and what they prioritize and stuff
Reserve
like
time.
I think it's going to be really interesting because there are actually a couple teams who haven't really played much on this patch just because they have been getting straight invites to tournaments. LGD and Secret
Team
also haven't
Secret's
met
turn
since
to
the
ban.
Frankfurt Major. They've managed to kind of
LGD's
be on
turn
different
to
paths
ban.
for the majority of lands, but they're ready to go. They were, hoping the lobby would start, and looks like they already have they're banning RTK on Secret.
I mean, I'm not surprised.
Team
ROTK is kind of
Secret's
like one
turn
of their
to ban.
biggest playmakers. Although it's kind of unfair to say that because Mavia has been more or less been doing a lot of work from the mid lane too.
Jason, I think you might need to up or
LGD's
lower your mic
turn to
threshold. You're
pick.
cutting in and out a little bit, but we will hopefully have that changed up. So in 1 second there. And yeah, it's gonna be the Invoker pickup immediately for Secret, so we get to see that one come out, and also an Oath Spirit ban, of course. So
I think it should be a lot better now. Sorry about that.
excellent. Yeah, no worries. I mean, it's first game of the night, folks. We have a long night ahead of us. Just to fill some of you in on the
10 seconds
format,
remaining.
it's round robin best of twos. You get a point per
Five
win, so there's none
seconds
of this. If you
remaining.
2-0 someone, you get 3 points. And
Witch
then
Doctor.
the top four teams of each group
LGD's
advance.
turn to
But if you're the
pick.
fourth team, you start in the lower bracket. If you're the third team, you play the other second team. And the first team, I believe, gets second round of. No, first team, sorry, plays third. And then, people get knocked down. So we will be seeing a Witch Doctor first pick by LGD Gaming. That's super uncommon, unless Chen has been picked up already.
We've kind of seen this first pick
10
Witch Doctor
seconds
thing
remaining.
during qualifiers. I think it's a really, really strong hero right at the moment.
5 seconds
Casca's always,
remaining.
incredibly
Tide
powerful,
Hunter.
and I feel like a lot of people have been playing the
Team
whole Death Ball
Secret's
strat
turn
kind of
to
thing,
pick.
so Voodoo Restoration's pretty incredible too.
Yeah, and now we're going to be seeing immediately the Tidehunter. I love this. I've been pretty excited to see some Tidehunter, and I mean, it's fun.
Yeah, it's
Also
one
a
of
bit
those.
of an ROTK hero coming out there.
It's one of those old school
10
laners, I
seconds
guess.
remaining.
I'm not too sure why he's getting picked up all of a
5
sudden. I
seconds
don't think there
remaining.
was many changes to him, so I'm kind of curious as to how ROTK picks or
Reserve
plays
time.
this Tidehunter. I realize that jungling Tidehunter is
Buzzer.
actually ridiculously fast with Iron Talons, so I'm
Team
pretty sure we're going to see
Secret's
Iron Talons
turn
right
to
now.
ban. Yeah, I think it's something where the Tide felt more viable with the large camp existing in the off lane, because obviously it's still hard to do ancients. You can stack that thing. It's actually really hard to stack, especially on Dire, so I'm a bit surprised.
10
But as you
seconds
said, you
remaining.
can potentially Iron Talon. You can maybe just feel like since you can get level 2 off of that camp, it's more sustainable in lane.
LGD's turn to
Lots
ban.
of different options and a dazzle. What patch is this, guys? I feel like, yeah. Some a little bit unusual picks.
Yeah, I mean, like I
10
said,
seconds
a lot of
remaining.
stuff has changed since the last patch. We haven't seen any
Five
of the top
seconds
teams
remaining.
showcase their hero selections. So we're just gonna have to wait and see how people are running these.
Reserve time.
I wouldn't be surprised as well. A lot of folks, we have only been on this patch for a month. It's something where a lot of stuff
Team Secret's
can
turn to
change in
ban.
that time, and people are still very much figuring out the patch. And this patch feels a lot more flexible than some previous ones. It's no hoo-hoo, ha-ha. Oh yeah, that is TeamSpeak pinging me. I have
Ten
to figure out how
seconds
to turn that
remaining.
off. Either way, we've got Naga Siren and the Morphling now coming out as
LGD's turn
bans.
to
In
ban.
case you guys don't know, obviously Sylar plays a bunch of Morphling, and he's actually one of the It's not on this patch. A lot of people have been trying the Morphling, and Sylar is one of those where he's like, "Oh, I'm actually madly successful at this hero."
Yeah,
Ten
I mean,
seconds
Sylar is one
remaining.
of the best Morphlings in the world. I'm a little confused
Five
by this at the
seconds
moment.
remaining.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but Eternal Envy is drafting for Secret right now.
LGD's turn to pick.
ROTK is drafting. Oh, sorry, EE is drafting for Secret right now. Yeah.
I don't think this has been a thing since the last time I've seen Secret play.
Yeah, it's definitely, as you said, it's a bit different. Oh, okay. One second. I have to fix something quickly, folks. Because TeamSpeak is pinging me for some reason. So just give me 1 second. You were saying, Eosin, E used to do this?
5 seconds remaining.
I mean, I know that E used to be a captain and all, but he has been drafting for Secret all the time. Reserve and time. All of a sudden, E is drafting. So I'm just kind of curious as to when they made this change.
Yeah.
Maybe after their most recent tournament, I don't think they do well.
I think it's definitely something where they weren't very happy with their results. Obviously, Secret hasn't been maybe placing as high as they would like, and maybe they're just trying something different. It's kind of funny because I feel like Puppy is very well known as an excellent, excellent drafter. So.
Oh yeah.
And. No doubt. Yeah. LGD Tidehunter and Morphling against EG during Star Ladder, and LGD won, and obviously, you know, EG came second, so LGD clearly showed that it's something they're very skilled with, and E being on top of knowing that and being like, hey, getting rid of that.
Oh yeah, yeah, for sure. I feel like LGD is like, they're very confident in their 5-man lineups, so I wouldn't be surprised if all these 5-man heroes are going to continuously get picked. I don't think they're too worried about getting split pushed because I think that's why they banned out like all the E split pushing heroes and stuff like that. And I think they're just going to aim for the mid game thing, like LG.
LG is a very strong team. They ban out Mercer for E. Everybody knows that E's M Spirit and something. Pick a whole bunch. Look at this.
Turn to pick.
I don't think I've seen picks this fast in quite a while. Especially on a lot. I don't know if it's just the late match did start about 5 minutes after when players expected to tell ready to go in lobby. But Avenge and then follow up.
Yeah, I mean, definitely their homework. I guess they kind of like what's expecting that kind of stuff, or probably have a plan. Stuff.
Team yep. Secrets turn to
Terrorblade, it is actually something kind of funny. Both Secret and LG have run Terrorblade before. I think the last time LG ran Terrorblade was actually a loss. I'm trying to, but it's something I mean, if you think it's gonna work, but you get a try. You do, it's a round robin, so you have better to all the way through, have a chance to adapt. If
10 seconds remaining.
It's kind of funny. Boca, though, I feel like that is very good at clearing.
5 seconds remaining.
Last time we played Terrorblade, it was against
Reserve Time.
Sure. And they dealt with it, what just fought that Terrorblade everywhere. He shut him down super hard. So I can only assume that Team Secret tried to replicate that play style. And I don't think Joker, you know, solutions was AOE. I think in a recent interview he was talking about powerful Terra players.
LGD's turn to
AOE even better. He could be and go away. Agree with them too. They were reflection change. It's really powerful team fights.
Yeah. It's, I mean, 10 seconds you said remaining. You can follow and stop it and shut it down. You can definitely get what you've done. But
5 seconds remaining.
I believe coming into this tournament is the team with the either highest or they have very high ranking to this which system you're using overall or more recent. And I wouldn't be surprised if LG would be able to pull out a successful strat that didn't work against EG against Team Secret. Also, maybe a tide protecting event, so holding it. I think it's a bit of an easy game for Terrorblade.
10 seconds
yeah, I'm
remaining.
Pretty sure they learned a lesson from last time they played. Just prepare
and
get shut down. And if you can't shut down, I'll blade him. Definitely fine. And then
reserve
turn
time.
Game around. He gets core right. Like that.
Reserve
yeah.
Time.
An excellent performer. A Nightmare and the Batrider. These are also pretty standard. LGD gets hands on the super popular hero right now. I'm actually a little bit surprised it took so long for it to come out. Especially since it's something which I feel Secret. So I think they would have been aware that it was such a great idea. And they got I get.
I mean, it's just standard LGD drafting style. All pick the incredibly powerful 5 ups.
They try to snowball. I speak
now they're
the
all
trees.
Selling. I do slow. So we can get out of control easily. The next profit, Mizrim is going to be able to really use the fact that there will cooldown still be. You just push very, and you know the Babbage, and that's 2.5 free pushing time. But we'll see how it actually ends up in the beginning. I don't feel like Nate's profit against a Witch Doctor Terrifying is particularly easy.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But at the time, they might be running like that. They could very possibly try to play something like I mentioned how Bull Genius did it. So it very might just. Dodging that three-round matchup, give Pyrion a one-up, so they can get to be 3
remaining.
Because their 3-3 up is really, really strong with Bark as well.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I mean, it's something. It's definitely a possibility to help, and then we finally into the game, folks. We're going to be seeing. Oh! Nice. Out of something. Sorry, keep. So why did they may have even seen the smoke, but they may have seen a smoke. But we already have an early TP out from LGD. This is pretty standard stuff, of course, being ones with the toss are going to get some work done, see if they can get one of those early symbols.
Oh, yeah. So, let's see how they're going to be. I think Secret, I mean, I don't believe Secret should. Fall terribly where we was. They tried not to. I think we're gonna something before it really gets side farm.
I'm not blocking on RTK. I don't think there's any way of blocking him. He do have to count completely off the mall from E. RTK, he hasn't actually skilled yet. He's by the way that he's taking a lot of damage. He's gonna get it! That's our first blood! And we're already doing it. Help now. RTK, for not scaling anything up, maybe a level in Broken Shell card in that.
I think he got a little. I can understand why I do that. It's kind of, you know, you don't want to throw away so easily because you really want to have the bank session. And at the time, it's kind of hard to remember that Invoker now is on Invoking. You know, you never expect a level 1 strike play. So
I think it's maybe just really trying to min-max on our Jason is popping up into the level 1 of strike point jungle, as you said, talent coming. This does make explain that he could have won because the Invoker's gonna start up the gold. But this
so, yep. And yeah, like I said, oh, actually, this is really unfortunate for RTK. Because he thought he survived that level 1 gank, and it's really important to jungle now because he doesn't have his anchor smash. That's really unfortunate for him.
Yeah, he said he thought he could survive smash, but it's not. Great, he at least have how he wants to be. And it does look like his profit takes full this new.
Yeah, I mean, this is one of the greatest changes about the new pack or offliners is that all these heroes that are capable of jungling at level 1 and stuff like that are kind of brought back into the game because of this. You actually have something to do.
But this is something we didn't talk about in the map, obviously. It's really one of the clues for this, right? It's very good at game, and he doesn't suspect that even lightning's too long. You often have to get yourself efficient.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of true, but at the same time, it's actually not bad at the end of that. Because of the range of arc lightning, you kind of just spam out waves and hide behind your tower. It is actually very difficult to gank a Zeus, at least in my opinion, because of his, you know, the way he just spams out waves. So.
So, we'll see exactly what comes out. But, I don't know, it's just chilling. They don't have any vision. They have vision over here. I guess they were expecting us behind. And at the same time, the revenge is standing right next to me. I get any sort of teleport. Was that your missile?
I'm kind of surprised LG went for that kill. I mean, Furion has boots, it's super difficult to catch him, and yeah, Puppy and Wii were there. Wii were ready to turn that around. It's a really good rotation from them.
It does feel like LG just I recognize it has been completely forced off in opposition, but it's a little bit hard when nature's popping so easily.
Funny enough, though, Misery, you kind of expected Furion to jungle fast, but Jungle Tide is pretty insane. He's level 4 already. Like, this farm, this jungle speed is incredible.
I was mouse about that. To, you know, say that's the pressure GD is feeling, but you're completely right. He's like, he can get his boots up, really going really fast, or gets an off turn. GD, a little, but you know, now I'm Misery is hard camp.
I think it's perfectly fine for LGD. The most important one is not to let Sylar die. Your supports die, you know, it's unfortunate, but it's not that big of a deal. The most important thing, yeah, is just to make sure your cores don't die. Once ROTK finishes his level 6 jungle, and he can just show up at fights. I don't think there's much Secret can do for the early game compared to LGD's early game. It's kind of situational. It depends on positioning of everyone in the game. I imagine that the best way to use it is to use it in lane where you can convert into tower push or something like that. So we're just gonna have to see where everyone's positioning is, picks up the
Yeah, and right now it does look like you can see the boss not doing really well on the Nova, as well as MV on the Nova. He's decided to go for the Midas Rush. This is actually something we see a lot, but he's just, I mean, he's had a completely free lane. I don't see any reason to go for this rush. There's no pressure on him.
I mean, this is definitely a good Midas, because like I said, LG's 5-man lineup is so strong, there's no reason for it to buy fighting items on Sark. You're gonna have to avoid fight for much longer than that, so you might as well just run a little faster, or a lot faster.
So, Pucker almost has arcanes, which is really nice for him. We see that also in Moker getting close to his Midas, it's a really stacked, slow game, kill them. Getting ready to all ready for the push, so we will see if that ends up for them. I think it's a lot that is playing can hang up the middle of the swords to get on.
It matters for Chiro, it's very important to give your supports some space, because right now the way the jungle works is just not viable for supports to only level off of blink camps and stuff like that. So if your support stacked for you, you're still going to get just as much, and then your supports are capable of getting up lanes.
Yeah. It's really stopping M1 getting any done, although it hasn't happened. I'm a little surprised on the profit, but both I you attempt tanking using the event, nothing really bad.
Oh, it's really difficult to tank secret lineup and vice versa, I feel, because you have so many ways of turning around fight. It's really risky to try to make picks and stuff like that, because you have two incredibly defensive heroes. So LGD's point, you just want to farm and prepare for the game, and they're farming really well right now, so I'm sure they're okay with this.
Yeah, take a look, we can see there's good instructions. It's pretty negligible, and especially when you see more of the characters. Yes, on is speaking of, he's gonna get on directing that up, and maybe even make it so terribly feels comfortable to push out a little.
Yeah, that ward set up a kill, maybe. It's really good for them. It's a nice little bonus. I don't think it matters too much. Like I said, waiting for the mid game to come on and stuff like that.
Got it.
Yeah. So he's fucking well. Who almost tournament? But there are a lot of fantastic teams that's been and those days of the group skate stage tournament. So a long time it had now. We do see Terra. We have about Silent. He's just gonna go Sanj and Yasha. Nope. And then maybe he gets thrown up.
Michael.
Another kill on involvement for not. And now we're gonna transition to a coach.
Oh, that was a really, really gank. They kind of beat LD to the timing, I suppose. Oh, RTK going down maybe.
Okay, yeah, he's definitely walking to that sun. Alright, even with the ground, get poked. Oh, that whole snap, and so many trancing there. I don't think there was much different than an easy mid tower. Now, do end up getting top tower with the tower. It's not one open jungle or anything, so I think you're very happy with this exchange.
Oh yeah, for sure.
The puppy, they put MM in that decision, and then strike with MM go on to the and they blow up puppy.
Yeah, the mid tower is incredibly important. It gives a lot of space to work with. You can easily walk into your opponent's jungle and stuff like that and put pressure on. That was kind of a misplay from LGD. I think they should have perhaps prepared for something like that, since they do have Ravage and Zeus ulti. They have a little 6 Witch Doctor as well. If there's a time to smoke, now's probably the best time to smoke. They easily take a tower with this.
Even though the other level 6s, I hang and roam up top with Ravage some, actually allowed them to get 6. They can take a team fight with just Baldur's Slog, always a slippery fellow with that Dark Pact.
Yeah, he's pretty tanky right now too, but they're sucked up, and oh, they can find him.
He's gonna break slot. Goes. It didn't pick on the not that they can thing with just which being so.
It's a really difficult gank to make, and they kind of caught him at one of the worst spots possible. But they're at least they're gonna get power out of this. There's no way Secret can come in to defend this at in time, and. They're just doing the right play, making trades. It's really good for Secret right now. Just avoiding the big team fight.
Obviously, this is not how that opens up the map super high. I think it's actually more important. You know, as Dire, you're a little bit happier to get this out. Just because it opens up so many smoke areas. Versus this tower, still really just. Yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. For sure. Most of it is just to do with controlling Roshan, if any. That's probably the most important one.
So we might have team fight engagement. We have Misery just chip away. Top tower pilot died. Sax himself. RK is working on that. He doesn't have it yet, but the rest of the. So we'll see if this turns into an engagement. He could snowball it at any time if he feels so inclined. But with team playing. Passively, but you know, some pretty nice spells here, I think.
Yeah, I mean, Secret's positioning is really good. They have all the vision they need. They just keep pressuring towers and avoiding fights and stuff like that. Just never want to engage against that red. And RLTK is kind of wasting a lot of time by not having the opportunity to use it.
Additionally, Secret's a good job of playing around their item pickups. They've got a mice on the Yoga, they've got a mice on the Slog. Those don't really show their potential until you pick up your items with them and also got necessary levels for them. So he does have duels, but kind of seeing Envy. I was going to go straight Saudi, which I have a Charles thing.
Yeah, it kind of depends on what they need. If they need to correct the whole splitting thing, Manta is. And I'm actually not too sure how Sarah builds his Terra Blade. We'll see.
Yeah. There should gain just. Actually, I feel so. It's not easy to say, but I'll be surprised if you go for the. I mean, it's cost-effective way to get the stat you want on an agi hero, and we'll take a big old step. That magic is basically something fun.
Yeah, I think they still have a bit more time. They're still really, really strong right now. It's not like. Kills, 4-2 kills is going to be a huge significant thing, so.
I mean, this game is pretty low on the kills, and pretty low on the impact and everything, and we're not seeing too much. Maybe the blade was actually going to stop the mother of your Terrorblade, and you do. I've seen a couple people go Sonya before this set. There's no real reason to stop floating around here.
Yeah, so I mean he does up for the Manta. Better farming and stuff like that. I'm not too sure if I agree with this though. I feel like LGD should realize that something has to happen. Okay, so now they smoke. But they have to do something because Secret has 3 Midases, and you don't want to go into a farming war against 3 Midases when your team doesn't have any, so.
And it's also working, realizing that LG has had so much trouble making anything. They're gonna try to fortify LG, but it's like, be that way, okay, Ravage is actually. See where they where the great fortress just gonna say hello before they expire, and we. About the wave cut, he's gonna kill Furia instead.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
I'm actually looking past you publicly since I think they would. They are going to team fight, obviously, but it's got something to take. Suddenly, through that you can shadow play to duck. I know it's a little bit difficult. And look at this.
Dire's top
tower. With very little blood. Look, have to be careful here. There's a step taking. He's already looking at it. They have popped a blow. And said, everybody's just gonna walk away. Suddenly comes out, gets onto Puppy. Should be the same page.
Light.
So when you get back in, we'll get there now. Yeah. Either way, you're just pulling your head and I'm getting powers, misery, field day, as you mentioned, there are 3 Midases here. How do you need time to do it? Obviously, on RMK will help. It's rough to force a team to choose.
But they do have Roshan still as an objective, so they can always just, go over there and take Roshan and force the team fight if Secret wants to deny them or contest the Roshan. I think the next play is probably going to be at Roshan.
I get a kill on somebody, pilot light is actually still up here. He's just being incredibly greedy because they haven't punished him for it yet. Now Salah's gonna be punched in, decides to actually quarterback it. It's not gonna be terribly exciting at all. Pilot died going down. He was just playing greedy.
I thought they were trying to use him as bait for some kind of objective, but I think that was just potentially just a greedy play by Pilai Dai. I mean, on the bright side, it still makes them some space, so not all the worst.
Nate Prophet also been, he'd been Pilai Dai behind him. How people thought that he was out there. Down bottom. Get rid of some of these trees. It is rough. We'll be seeing and a bit of damage here, walking in on that Scotty. Oh, but in the mid lane, RTK taking a lot of Weehawk down here. There is just gonna be some at the rate of RTK.
I sprout anew.
Yeah, that was, yeah, Wii is actually massive now. The power of Midas. So LGD still aren't able to get much done, and Secret are perfectly happy with that because, like I said, three Midas, they're gonna outlevel them, outfarm them, and probably.
I think as well. Here wise, I'm much happy to have Cool and an Aegis back up, then and stuff like Galati and just a template.
Well, the thing about that is Zeus is incredibly powerful at every stage of the game, so I think LGD are fine in terms of, you know, late game and stuff like that. It's pretty even for in terms of late game in my opinion.
And on the Roshan that you talked much about, hopefully this ups thing, if Spirit puts on Sentry, still he won't be, but they'll get this. Obviously, LGD, they can actually get a lot of work on this. You know, I love sorry that, you know, long the nature lives, this will come over them.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, LGD, they want to try to fight, but Secret are not going to fight them. Like, they have no reason to fight them. They can just keep farming. And then, I mean, even more so now, they just have to keep split pushing. And I think they can only defend high ground. At the same time, though, it's so hard for LGD to reach high ground because of this immense split pushing coming out of Secret. So.
Okay. And then you get sort of pushed that because you have lead pressure from the Nature's Prophet.
Oh, here comes a gank on Furion.
And that we're gonna be seeing misery. Oh, they are thinking about using the Ravage. They actually see the base. Zeus tongue. There are a few folks nearby, and as you said, it's gank on. But they can't continue because Top's pushing.
Yeah, I think they made the right decision not to solo Ravage the Furion. If you solo Ravage the Furion, then it gives even more space to Secret because they know that you're not going to try to, you know, push towers or anything if you don't have your Ravage.
And Pad has already brought a gem for the team. Invoker's rocking that up. He's halfway to an Aghanim.
Yeah, this is actually looking rough for LGD. They're just getting pushed on all ends. They're gonna try to force this bottom tier two tower, so we're gonna have to wait and see how Secret try to play this out. My guess is they give it up, perfectly fine, push each other stuff.
I'm really unsure how you force team to engage that doesn't have any desire to. Like, Secret okay with giving up this town, maybe gonna put Mr. Elsa waiting either or he is. I can actually see. Actually, picking up a lot of gold. Going on it. Yeah, he's got his skull.
The standard Stark build.
So, what if I come even with Ravage, right? I'm not sure if they'll win. And if they do win one team fight, Ravage is going to last much longer than his death time at this point.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, while that's true, I mean. Fortified. It's not like their team fight is completely over and done with if Ravage is gone. I think maybe he's gonna buy Double Nyx. so that it can push out lanes and also push towers like this. So we should probably see boost of travel right now.
And maybe, yep, as you said, travel trying to make all the bacon kill that work done. There's only something to be said, I don't know. If they are taking a base trade, they can potentially delay it on LGD and things like the router stop. Because they have a lot of TP stoppers, let them push something, right? Silo should be called.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
This is really good for LGD right now. Because of how strong Maybe is right now, they actually can't do the what they intended to do. Oh. The whole split push. Oh.
You said that though, someone's gonna be doing a hold to the face. Maybe is immediately pushed. Maybe it gets something, but we hard to walk. He's gonna TP out and he has his Aghanim Scepter.
That was really good bait by EE. I guess maybe expected only Slark to be there. I don't think he expected Invoker to be there because the rest of his team was pressuring high ground and stuff like that. He probably assumed that Invoker was air ready to counter initiate in case anything happened mid lane. EE baited it out and maybe he's dead.
And now GD or in base. Don't push out terribly, don't have his own scope picked up, but he is still actually sitting around his now. This town in committing him. Go next.
My guess is you would probably pick up BKB. Because I think he's at the stage, like just these two items and a BKB. He's strong enough to just walk into a team and like just force everyone to fight. He can tank everything, do whatever he wants. BKB, just they can definitely go into high ground with
It's something to note about damage. If Slaw is hitting you, yes, a lot of that damage is very physical, but of course, Invoke all that damage is contribution. A lot of it's going to be magical with Wrath of Nature and it's going to help out. Or Tyrant, he managed up at those Golden Greaves and the Aegis just so. Depending on how long the Gorn was in.
It's about a minute and a half, 2 minutes?
No, yeah.
Is that the 8 minute
mark?
Oh, I see. Okay, I see.
Now we know it's gonna be a 10 and a half spawn. There we go. That's long.
Oh, secret sense. Yeah, incoming smoke gank.
Is not, you know, I thought rule about massive there, guys. I thought say obviously both a lot online. This is a pretty big line. It's also a lot of this team is a great opportunity on new patch to play. Under attack.
Oh yeah. This is this is the first time a lot of these teams have been playing officials the patch, so.
Especially the teams that play through qual, for example, G really has nothing else. And no official match. Some P item progression going on. Even P is pretty much that as an interval in this game. I mean, that's how I have money. But people, Jeffrey's team. And Joker is the blue.
Did you just see that? Top lane? He almost solo killed Sylar with his combo. Sylar accidentally walked with a meatball and almost killed himself. And then sundered ROTK. That was pretty funny.
Now apparently the last time I was playing as well, picked up a BKB next. Not bad either, because again, while there's certainly lots of damage coming out of Terrabid, avoiding getting flat. That Ravage not having to deal with all the spam is fantastic. So speaking of not having to deal with the gank of the DD, okay, maybe stand down. And comes up and just hit him a couple times. They do some nasty pieces coming in, but Zeus dead before they can do anything. And then FMY being gone, pop anything into the sun. DDC is now already fighting. There's two down and taking a lot of damage. That's the Shadowblade back up, and Aurora to say he goes, but he doesn't need to, they see, and they're gonna keep him in range. Zeus does it! Oh, he doesn't have the ult to use. One auto attack will get the kill on Envy, and a huge goal, but the tower's being taken, and we and Misery back on out. They've achieved productive force.
Yeah, that was real close for LGD. If they let Slark get away with that, that would have been pretty terrible for them. It's bad enough that they're still pretty bad for them, though, in my opinion, having to lose your tier 3 tower stage.
For LGD, space of justification here. See, pulling ahead, they're able to get more out of the map due to their minuses, when they just rock and fall everywhere. So, have a really
good
time.
LGD have to wait for the next Roshan, and then I feel like it's kind of like they just have to, when they go, they just have to go for it and probably just clear out 2 lanes of racks and kill the people, you know. And since their tier 2s are still up, I think that perfectly fine for them to trade Raxes, because I think LGD are strong enough to take 2 lanes of Raxes if Secret decide to trade with them, they're one, so.
We will be having, again, just a little bit of a... This Roshan, don't realize it's almost max Roshan spawn time, and... Top one's also right there. Check that, he's gonna check both the ward and the tree coming by. On the ward down, of course, the witch... gem, how they were empty before, but Sila gonna come up. Sila has a play. Actually, there it is. Surprise be showing up and being out taking a lot of damage despite that. Sila does care. In BB. Highlight, I saw it. Now Sila, we have to run out of the game. MMI, and we'll be able to get the goal. Good at school, but like, hi. Now, Sun, the combat. Support RG. Is that, you know, the only match?
That was, I mean, so many of Secret just got away with so little health. Like I said, this is how strong LGD's team fight is, even without Ravage. I think Team Secret thought that they could fight him just because Ravage was down, but nope. LGD played that out really well and still managed to win the team fight.
Additionally, it was very impressive. Of time, Neuroblade managed to buy. He can't buy. Albeit there was, you know, that was his 10-second ticket, but that was a hell of a. And he managed to stay alive. And this is how Paris of MD Palm say that. On way out of no man's land.
That was,
Okay, I mean, he's coming. He doesn't eat. If BKB cool down, they could go for BKB. Oh, it's broken away at the last pop. Is the next. They're eventually gonna fall. Trying to get RTK as they actually could really just trying to get from Misery. And we'll see if they can put anything on the back. They push off MMY. When it goes down here, though, broken up. See his face just be away the death. No, they don't see. And now RTK to look around needs, though. But this slowing down, he's seeing a lot of damage to the creep. Shall he in the back and he is dead.
What a, that was such a chaotic fight.
Oh, yeah, we have a little bit of anxiety. Still being stunned here and being poking Sunder on himself. But the matter of life in the future, he knows the one is dead. Now EE dead, have lost, making kill off the creep that they're TPing. Zeus does manage to get the kill with his, but looking to be and So next time you first, and I think you up. So I'm gonna because I just put it back because it was doing downtime. That takes that up. So the team they feel a little bit in favor to get rid of this immediately and didn't much or kill on making this is the rich. Seeing he of course still has done that I put him back a bit making some progress. So and anyway, and what do you feel? I'm fresh probably what's up next on high sides not to go for fishes.
I think wait, is it okay now? I mean I can never tell if it's okay.
It actually sounds fine now.
Okay, I thought it stays that way. But, I think Refresher is... It's always gonna be, you know, a really, really good item for Tidehunter. I think it's probably better than Shiva, because they do need the... I kind of feel like they are lacking lockdown at the moment, because everything is projectile, such as... I want to say slow projectile, but it's still kind of not instant. So Ravage is kind of like their only really instant kind of disable. So Ravage is perfectly fine here. Or fresher.
Dark light. It's kind of a game because it has been at 1,000. Top barracks are under attack. Managed to keep it only at 1,000 I think it's actually pretty good. Things considered, the lead hasn't continued to grow because they should still be able to in secret get more out of the map with pieces.
Yeah, for sure. Maybe it's Blink. That was sick.
Maybe
how did he know?
These guys have, right? I mean, I feel we all these games. There's been some stuff here. I just don't always see in order to go to see. But folks are coming immediately. A lot of things. Not.
I'm kind of surprised he still went through with that travel spell. There's not much reason to do it, but style points for him. Enjoyed it.
Yeah, I think it's. There's been some ballsiness. We are. He is. You can request the tools. You can. It's the might so inclined, but you know, it looks like Mike seems to come up on the air. He is coming from weak puppy. Is it his feet as well? Let's get a proc onto maybe and mice split everywhere. Puppy is up full. Always BKB used.
Let's see. Oh, yeah, that was this is gonna be a really slow game.
Oh my god, we just playing with this dude.
I mean, yeah, Weeha is just doing his thing. It's so hard for them to catch them because of his, you know, how mobile he is and stuff like that.
Ball has ball. Zeus and that's gonna get the spirits. Now there is an ancient. Team might go I think secret have a lot of different options plays. Again, they've got to this to the game where secrets are just gonna take all of your maps and feel almost through the getting just on the his teeth. Poof right there.
Yeah, this is the way this game is gonna work out is just that. Oh, it's DDC. DDC is fine. It's a good item, but yeah, LGD. The way they have to win this game is they just have to maintain the kind of gold differential because the way their team comp is, they're still gonna win even with a 10k gold difference. I think they're still stronger right now, in terms of team fight. and you know, they're just waiting for Secret to make a mistake, but Secret are willing to, you know, be patient at the same time. So nothing is really happening. You're gonna have to wait for Roche number 3, probably Roche number 4, and I'm
cool. Puppy gonna be him, but
gonna take the kill on Puppy, doesn't
I don't think so. It's a small, it's obvious it helps, but nothing major in my opinion.
Yeah. How many people the ability need to kill? Huge.
Silo is just all over the top. I mean, obviously, it's just probably like a big deal, but even then, you like something. Okay, a big red coming up hard to get a cat misery. They can get this kill, but he is probably be silent. I'm gonna be woken up on misery. They should be able to get a kill, and yet, he will get him down.
I don't think it's enough, fortunately. If you look at the state of the lanes right now, everything is still pushed into LGD's side. Misery is dead for 1 minute, he can buy back if he needs to, but I don't think they're gonna have enough time to do anything. But having Misery dead alone is definitely not enough. So you're just gonna see everyone go back into a farm fest.
I think they just come down to one big thing, right? Whereas, well, probably two, because people are uncomfortable, buyback, right? And we're very close on having back. So even if you're gonna break the joke, or there's gonna be a sound strike, but they're trying to do a little bit of the food coming. They managed to bring him down. It's gonna overlap somewhat with the nature of its death time.
Okay, this is... let me see. Okay, unfortunately, they still can't push anything because the way the lanes are right now. But that was much more important than Puppy. Delaying their core is obviously much better than delaying a support, but like I said, you still can't get anything done. And in terms of buyback, I don't think Secret have to worry too much about having buyback, whereas LGD really have to worry about it. Because if you don't have buyback on LGD, mostly you're going to be losing Raxes. Whereas Secret, probably not so much, not as afraid.
It's not easy, right? Honestly, for folks. And
this, is,
like,
this is a good opportunity for LGD now, though.
Even
they're just going for it.
There is on the lineup, EE. Have to use it, that's really. Most in back here. They do the top of work. The top of the meatball comes out. Actually, Evan being swapped on feet. Damage has that. They pursue because the character isn't like big. Immediately, not task.
They're just buying time. They're just wasting time. They're taking racks right now.
And as you said, that as my three, we'll be seeing if they get more. And they can't. They can't get the mid tower. And so now it's gonna be KBTP. Wait, don't swap up, right? And...
yeah, so I mean, everything just kind of more or less resets. You have to wait for Roshan again on LGD. I think the way this game is to go now is that maybe it's not that dire for LGD, but I kind of predict that. Way LGD win this game is you just have to keep waiting, and when you go for it, you just win the game. Like whatever they decide to do, you just all in at one push. So
this is the second max. I was short die of max, but this one is like we're gonna see a Zeus ulti out in the map. Everybody's gonna scatter.
Yeah, I'm sure they realize that Roshan is also. I mean, they also realize that Roshan's about to be up. So, this Roshan area is gonna be really important the next few moments.
A secret it up for fight the LGD costly. Please be cautious at top racks with monks. We push it right now.
They just gotta keep pushing out the lanes. They just have to keep pushing the lanes. LGD, oh, they're gonna smoke. This is a good timing, actually. They know their position for it.
Okay, going to on. I see if they find anyone. Envy, he immediately pinged that they are out and about, and now look, they'll only be able to find him. Yules is up. They'll get down to the bottom behind the wall that works on this top tower. So they actually get Gem out. A much bigger and support kill. Immediately have to die, and Envy, they don't take shots on things.
Yep, this is smart play by Secret. They realize that LG have to go back to defend, and once they all go back to defend, they go for the rush themselves.
Yeah. Looking to all for E. Yeah, right now. The 500 deaths of this farm. So they do get. Can they bring him down? That's the question.
Oh, for sure. Sark isn't that strong at the moment. They have a sheep stick on maybe, so they've been doing the whole swap into sheep thing, like the immediate sheep, which is pretty much gonna kill anyone on their team right now.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about obviously Nature's Prop has picked up the MK for the butterfly, but maybe need one eventually too?
Yeah, I think so. I think he needs one. Eventually. Once they find, decide to fight. What was that?
They get extra slot. So they just kinda thing. He is a boss.
He never has to leave a lane if he wanted to. He can just constantly pressure one lane. It's almost impossible to kill. They have to really count him out with the sheepstake if they want to kill him.
Again, taking those backs is. They have their fresh idea, and this is a decision to make, because of course, if you get off savages, it's great, but if you get off like, and you're fresh, it's kind of like, okay. Now, Puppy, maybe again, gonna be out, he gets off savages, just hoping to get away, but he isn't able to see exactly where he is. Still hoping on the Twilight Die will push out Grave to come up the latest. Well, Voka has been in the you will just hold the BBs.
Are under attack.
That was a huge team fight for Secret. That's two wretches down. If there's any time you're gonna go for the Rax push, like now is their time. So they have to get something done with that team fight one.
So I mean, as we go, looking over our status, please don't let them go. Also, that they lose. Good. Also, a lot of PKs broke, and most certainly not on the just on the wall, taking a lot of damage. Mm-hmm. They will finish him off, and poking up that play back in that they get a one big count. Oh, also thrown out, and Dial is just basically like taking a lot of damage. Will they catch anybody else?
Dyer's oh, is it going down?
I don't know.
It's fine. I think Tinker kind of played that a little greedy. I think Weehaw was a little too confident in his ability to survive. But I guess he underestimated the Zeus's sheep stick. And if you get picked off like that, then instead of, you were originally going for two objectives, now you just kind of get one. You'd get the tower, and that's it. You couldn't even finish off the top racks.
One of the lines locked. It's over a different lineup. You'd end up going for and they can see value in the line against and swap the jeeps. There are quite a few things to play it. Just one second. Any amount that you use that dog, right?
Pretty yeah, I think Lincoln's is right now. Because, I mean, the only way Stark is going to die is if he gets cheap. And if Pilot Eye isn't there to save him, I feel like that's the only way he'll die. So, probably a next pickup that before.
Yeah, I also did. I want to get some really good cool plays around. I mean, this starts slow, pick team fight action, but the support players have been so.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. There's been great wood placement, but goodness, just such efficient. Yeah, they see him, what we're. The wolves and the. You know about it. Over 10 feet. He's coming and they time and catch the. Back to the rabbit. He's going to land here. Keep on. He's going to go. So now our cable. A rabbit. He throws it out. But in that beat. Build the horror TKL. Oh, wait. He's going to get it. Another fight there working. We are death ward, but he's. See, that being a bearing when they stop the Zeus following him so easily. Then in the end, the end that fight. But the kill Envy again.
That was, I say it's still kind of fair-ish of a raid. Because you had to use two Ravages, and unfortunately the second one didn't even do anything.
Oh,
well. You burned a cheese.
How did they deal with Sila? Sila's been staying alive. He's on Valley sometimes. Done for other people. There's a lot of tricks that you're in your book. He's in work.
Yeah, Sylar is really, really good at this game. I feel like there's a lot of times he should have died, but he always finds, you know, that correct target to Sunder. Stays alive. And he just destroys Envy at the moment.
This is kind of commend MMI, because MMI didn't tell us Sunder. He's done. Correct, but, you know, I can imagine that MMO was like, well, the DD had to sell like what the people actually found. And interestingly, which is a completely out.
I think that's perfectly fine. I actually really liked this build. I think having stats over Maledict is fine. Because you have to put yourself in such a compromising position just to cast that spell, so.
Yeah, and it hasn't gone for the Aether Lens. It's valid to launch to be close to the array, and then Aether Lens, of course, makes it easier to hugely help the positioning tools for. We really want to vent either.
I think that contributes to it, for sure. But, I mean, all these utility items are doing so much work for them, I can only assume that they just realize that these.
Oh, ROT. Okay, tornado. I think tornado, but we get more. Is still there.
I wonder if that would actually do enough damage. We're trying to do the Fury on Wrath of Nature, and then he's gonna Sunstrike it, strike bench for the kill. I don't think it would do enough damage, but it would have been nice to see.
The Sunstrike is a little over 500. Of course, the tornado and Nature's Wrath are gonna do, you know.
Yeah, it's really hard to see. Yeah. I don't think it does enough. But it would have been cool to see. It would have scared MMY pretty.
So, it definitely puts the fear in your house, right? You're down a rain rack, you've got people on the team who can do damage to you whenever you're low, maybe you. What is Tyler? Do you ever play? I don't feel like this. Is there ever maybe he could pop out the 5-second BKB in the. You know, some careful Korean.
That's really, really hard to say. I feel like if you're gonna swap out any item, it's gonna have to be Manta. And I'm not even sure what you would replace it with. Maybe.
I mean, he already consumed a moonshot, right?
He's more or less maxed out. He can do whatever he wants right now. He's 8,000 gold, so. And he has boosted travel too. It's kind of to say. Maybe, I don't know. Twice. Courier, Michael, or Refresher or something.
No, we actually. All players already level 25 in this game. Out join the. Like. We're. Get up there. So. It's. Actually, this is going to be over just because of the way we're having an advantage. We take a look at what they managed to bring back on LDD. I. A bit. Get some offs there. Experience. Still pending up towards Secret, but, you know. Still
mad because
everyone's
alive. Yeah, I mean, so this was kind of expected when you just see how this game was played out. LGD just have to keep waiting for their one moment to just game. Secret just keep chipping away, but LGD's defense is. I feel like just losing ranged racks and two towers this stage of the game already really. Impressive.
Yeah, I definitely have. I actually thought Secret would have been able to. I just basically go by now getting some pickoffs, but they have. I did want to point out a routine we taking a lot of damage. There's a lot of damage. Silas got the poke come down from your yules, and he does die back, but if he uses it, won't have that refresher.
Yep, LGD just playing it smart, waiting for opportunities, that's doing a lot more. And now Roshan is up, they get another Roshan, they just wait for another opportunity.
Hey wait, I didn't actually see the timer, I'm assuming that we should maybe not. Now, I haven't talked to Roshan because there has been a bit of action. Hype's been up on the for a while, there's a gym handle over the base, you know, every 6 months. There are two Jezzes just like this right now because how they transferred. Tusk will probably eventually get angry. I think saving for buyback now. Nature's Prophet also being slotted.
Oh, he's ready to get slotted.
Yeah. Do you ever.
Gold, so.
Do you ever swap fake boots for, I don't know, more magic?
Yes, you definitely do. It's nice to have two teleportations because you can. Instantly push out a lane and then just go help your team. LGD are going in.
It's going in to push. They're also trying to get their top lane. Maybe just to be able to get rid of them. And it is just. Of course, this game. Actual is that.
I mean, it's definitely a really nice out right now because it just kind of makes it a little easier to keep your lanes pushed out. Now the mid lane, they don't have to worry as much about the middle. I think Secret didn't want to fight that, but they had Aegis and Cheese, and if you lose a team fight in your base right there, you just lose. You can do.
Completely. Now, I don't know if you saw, but EE has an epic terror that says, I'm useless. I saw the Dragon Blade when it interacts. Cheese is expressing his opinion on the hero himself. He's ready to get that
above. That's kind of funny.
Yeah. Always enjoy the. Unfortunately, or fortunately, the game has had no pauses or anything. No pauses off the game to look around. Smoke, it feels like it's been forever since we've seen these on the Radiant.
They're setting up for bottom. I guess they're ready to fight. They're going for it.
It's still, of course.
Oh. Okay.
I thought that they with the hound, but no such luck here. Okay, and I'll have the god angry kick being used as time now, and no, they're gonna look at each other coming in from this cat. They won't get up pressure, it's on to the and now way his beat, but RT has done his job, doesn't matter how they come in. This man, the buyback misery, he got to see about it. Come back. He's sitting in the mountain, floating very low, going down. Misery doesn't. He took a long time to sit on his quarterback. That was a complete win by LGD.
The power of double ravage. That was really, really, really good positioning from RTK. is Double Ravage just destroyed Secret.
I'm still confused. I feel like in Alta we already used to be KB that has been at 5 seconds while.
I mean, LGD positioning was just like far superior. They were so split up. No one stacked. Everyone's so split up, and if everyone splits up, it's so hard for Secret to target anyone because you can't kill supports because they have, you know, ghost scepters and stuff that. If you try to target anyone else, they get swapped. It's so difficult to fight LGD right now. I'm kind of surprised they even took that fight to begin with.
I needed Radiant's bottom tower. The game since Isla is. It's pretty much what he's going to do with Hurricane. No, grab this Glimmer Cape, quickly saving his life. Just is all the equipment. Stun up his he could just fucking get off on a DDC. No, I'm quite sure if that's all you want. It, that was a bit. They do throw a bunch of trees. Stop some push, but it's gonna play things. Sign up away at their racks. Now, jump forwards. I'm trying to TP. And now there's another melee round there to help you guys. But again, he's being caught out there. He's actually about to taste and what he's doing. Everybody thinks they have gone down. Something about the behind is maybe he throws a ice ball at a meatball, hoping some, but it's not looking like it's been stay walking away. It's not a way illusion. Still dig doesn't even matter. Misery one more zap to kill him. That means dieback terror.
I think that should be game. Well we saw his tipping up top, he's trying to go for throne and stuff like that.
Yeah,
LGD just goes for the end of the game.
And he had no back there, and as you said, G call. And spring is game one. Dang exciting.
LGD. That was really good play from both sides. They both understood what they had to do. The biggest mistake, I think, was just that team fight at bottom where Secret decided to go fight them. I don't think that's necessary. They should have just kept doing what they wanted to do. But other than that, like, both teams, you know, followed their strat, what they wanted to.